Hey, in this lesson, we're going to get negative. No, not that kind of negative. I'm more of the glasses incorrectly sized kind of guy anyway. We're going to talk about negative numbers and how we store negative numbers in Java. If you're not sure how computers store negative numbers differently, you'll definitely want to keep watching this video. The goals for this lesson are to understand how we store negative numbers in binary. This is also how numbers are stored in Java. We're going to use something called 2's complement numbers. Now let's start with what we know. We talked about binary numbers in the last lesson and how they're organized to represent positive numbers. Each digit represents a power of 2. This is like the normal power of 10 numbers we already use. So how does it work with negative numbers? Well, your first thought might be to sacrifice the first digit and use it as a sign bit. Let's try that. Let's start with 3-bit numbers and add minus 3 and 2. The first number will be 111. That will be our negative 3. And then we'll add 010. That's our 2. Add it and we get 001. Or 1, wait. Minus 3 plus 2. That didn't work. We should get 101 as a result. The answer is negative 1. Maybe if we add special code for the sign bit? But how do we know when to do that programmatically?
The problem with this strategy is it introduces a bunch of cases. A case for 2 positive numbers, a case for 2 negative numbers, a case where the positive number is larger, a case where the negative number is larger, a case where the positive and negative number add to 0. This completely wrecks our simple adder. It won't work.
Okay, time out. Now I'm going to take an aside. We need to talk about something else that might help and come back to this problem later. Imagine a clock. On the clock, you have the numbers from 1 to 12. If it's 3 o'clock and you had 12 hours, it's still 3 o'clock. We're not looking at days here, just the hour. If we add 3 hours, that makes it 6. Add 15 hours, that's still 6. If we subtract 9 hours, yep, still 6. This works for multiplication too. You can try that one at home.
The reason this works is 3, minus 9, and 15 are all equivalent numbers for a clock. It doesn't matter which one you use. You get the same number in the end. The math way to say this is that they are all congruent modulo 12. Don't worry, that's not on the quiz. So, back to binary land. How can we use this information for our computer numbers?
We do the same thing for our numbers. Imagine our computer holds 3 bits. We're only using 3 bits because I want to show you every possible number. On a computer, the numbers vary from 8 bits to 64 bits, and that's just too many to display here. Now think of the numbers as positions on a clock. We'll map our numbers this way. The first bit still means negative, but the other bits are not how we represent positive numbers. For example, minus 4 is 100 and minus 1 is 111. So the positive numbers look the same, the negative numbers look weird. What happens now? Well, let's try adding minus 3 and 2 again. So we add 101 and 010. That gives us 111, which is minus 1. It works. No special logic. It works because these are equivalent numbers in binary. So how do we calculate the special number when we're using 16 bits? Well, there's really no magic to it. To change the sign of a number, all the bits are flipped and you add 1. Earlier we had minus 3. So 3 in binary is 011. Step 1, flip the bits to get 100. Then we add 1. So the complement number is 101. Just like on our clock. If this number were 8 bits, the number would be 11111101. So the number of bits in your mapping matter to calculate the correct equivalent number. Luckily, this is all handled for you behind the scenes. However, it is important to understand what your computer is doing.
So this is why we use 2's complement for all numbers in Java. There are no unsigned numbers in Java. Every counting number type is doing this for negative numbers. For some of the larger number types, there are ways to use them unsigned, but we can't cover that until we get to number classes. That's a ways away. In the next lesson, we'll actually look at our first type, the byte. Hey, thanks for watching the video. There's a quick quiz for this on DGU.com if you'd like to gauge how much you learned. If you like the videos you're seeing, please let me know by liking the video and hitting the subscribe button for the DGU channel on YouTube. I'd really appreciate that. If you have concerns or questions, please leave them in the comments below or on DGU.com. There's a poll on the front page of DGU.com, so you can also let me know what topic gets covered next. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.